It's another day cooking with Debbie. Hey, what I mostly use for my marinates is, if you can find this is really good stuff. You want to get a lot of garlic in your food. I mean, I believe in it because it just really makes things taste good. It's called Brianna's Homestyle Caesar Dressing. Super good on a salad, but really good as a marinade. It's thick. And it's not too vinegary or anything like that. It just puts a really good flavor, lots of good garlic flavor to it. And then soy sauce has tons of salt in it. So you just want to use a little bit of that, not too much of that. And then I just do a little bit of a Worcestershire sauce. So everything I do, I kind of tantale. I don't do, a fourth a cup of this and a third, 4 tablespoons of this. I just tantale, which is my mom's favorite word. And I usually mix it all up in a cup. You know, I just pour a little bit in there. Not too much Worcestershire sauce because that's pretty strong. And then this is very salty, so you don't want too much of that either. I don't know, that's probably is a fourth a cup. And then I had already put some on there because I was doing another video and it was kind of weird. But so then if you like pepper, you want to add a little bit more pepper to your seasoning too. So then what I do, you know, more pepper because Dawn likes a lot of pepper. Then what I do is I mix it up real good. A lot of times I'll add some wine to it, a little for the cook and a little for the recipe. But no, really. Add a little wine to it sometimes. And see, this is kind of still thick because I put a bunch of that stuff in. So then I put it on there and you can put it in the crock pot. And what I do is I leave the fat in there. I didn't know this, but like about probably 12 years ago, I learned that you should really actually leave the fat in your meat because it cooks and makes it nice and moist and everything. Dawn cuts out every little bit of fat, and I used to do that too. Well, I found out that you really shouldn't do that, and I actually have a daughter out there that loves to eat the fat. Ew. But anyways, no, but yeah. So see, and it's kind of a beige color. Ooh. Okay, so you can put this in the crock pot, and I'm just gonna flip it over because I'm gonna do the other side. You can put it in the crock pot, but I'm gonna let it marinate. This time we're gonna put it probably on the grill. And if I put it in the crock pot, you don't have to let it marinate. You just put it in the crock pot, let it cook 5 hours on high or 8 hours on low, like if you're gonna be gone all day. And then it's already ready for you. So I'm flipping them over so I can get the other side, and then I'm gonna put pepper on it because he likes pepper and I do too. And then I'm just gonna let it marinate all day, and then when it's time to, you know, you can just let it, you can let it marinate for a couple hours if you don't have time. Even 2 hours is sufficient. So flipping these over, and we're gonna do the other side and then see how it turns out. I hope it turns out good. I'm sure it will. It always turns. And I do this on chicken, sometimes on my pork, if I'm cooking, you know, a pork roast or something like that. And a lot of times I use just the crock pot or even my pressure cooker. I'll use that too. So there you go. That's all there. And then I'm gonna put some pepper on top and then it should be good. All right, hope you enjoyed my Debbie's cooking video.